All life is only a set of pictures in the brain, among which there is no difference betwixt those born of real things and those born of inward dreamings.
Safest shores, for there are things that cannot be undone.
Dr. Faust, is that you?
Was about to explode. This device, its noises are resonating in my mind.
Hello? Anybody here?
Where is everybody?
Locked.
Looks like we're having a power problem right now.
Successful establishment of the Upper Watt Antarctic base.
And after that, nothing is clear in my mind.
What was that?
Stuck. Oh, it smells awful in here. This is Frank Gilman. Can anybody hear me? Over. It's no use.
It's stuck.
Thank you. it's locked.
If his coat is just right here, where is he now?
Locked. It's locked. Stuck.
Who are you?
I'm Frank. Frank Gilman.
Is that so?
Is there a problem with that?
My name is Frank Gilman, an anthropologist joining this expedition upon the invitation by Venerable Dr. Faust himself.
This thing is claiming that it's me. That's absurd. Why? You're claiming that you are me, Frank Gilman, but you are just a machine.
And you are just air.
Air? What do you mean by that? It doesn't answer me. Where is everybody?
They are here.
I don't see anybody around. Are you sure?
Yes.
What do you know about Dr. Faust?
He is the Grand Mastermind and the pioneer of this expedition.
Okay, Frank. Tell me, why are you here exactly?
I am here because of my extensive knowledge on the human pineal gland, I am one of the Canarinauts.
Canarinaut?
Voyagers beyond.
Beyond? What beyond? No answer. Did I lock my door? I don't remember where my keys are. Locked. It's locked. If his coat is just right here, where is he now? This is Upuwat Expedition Base. Pequod, please come in. I repeat, this is Upuwat Expedition Base. Pequod, do you hear me? If there is someone who can hear me, please, come in. Some electrical condition in the disturbed air seems to prevent communication.
Stuck.
Unfortunately, one of our researchers, C. Lenning, was found dead in the biolab last Tuesday. Cause of death is currently uncertain, but judging by the accumulation of a mass of green substance found in his mouth and throat area, Dr. Barlow, our botany expert, thinks that Lenning was smothered by small, sticky, greenish clumps that look like pollen, belonging to the living samples of the plant Sahiti, which is thought to have become extinct during the Paleozoic era. Dr. DeWitt will perform a post-mortem examination on his body soon.
What is this? It's impossible to determine with so much decomposition. Oh, yes. These are the pre-human species we found frozen in a cave far south of the base.
Thank you.
believe. No more can we harbor ourselves on the safest shores, for there are things that cannot be undone. I think you should retire to your room. I'm going to think a bit more.
It's locked. Locked. Thank you.
Unfortunately, one of our researchers, C. Lenning.
Stuck. It's stuck. It won't open.
I don't know if you can hear me, but I am trying to search it. It is the only way.
Hey! Hey, can you hear me? Damn it! Who was he? Anyone here? Dr. James? Dr. Morgan? Anybody? Where are they, for God's sake?
Looks like something's missing here.
Hey, this is amazing. Most of the ground level structures have been crumbled and rounded from untold eons of savage storms, and thus weathered into shapeless ruins. However, Both the ground level and the cavern systems below are clearly displayed in these bas-reliefs. The most striking features depicted in this grand panorama, I believe, are the tall, occasional towering spires, which somehow resemble a lighthouse. They all seem like focusing a light beam towards a colossal structure in the center. Could there be some sort of religious meaning behind this? Or simply something that has a more practical use? I'm not sure.
This is the strong light that can be seen from ground level.
These ivy-like plants are blocking the way.
Thank you.
What was that I've just seen?
Mistaken. This relief depicts that the overgrown flora we came across at the various points in the cavern can be cleared away with an iridescent device, a tool or a talisman. Curiously, we still haven't been able to find the roots of those plants. They seem to seep out of these caverns by passing through crevices which look as if intentionally made for them. What other secrets might these silent halls conceal from us?
plan, my team will continue exploration through this gateway. Other expedition parties can commence when ready.
Looks like something's missing here.
The same set of symbols we've seen in strangely carved niches all around here matches with what is written in the oldest parchment. I believe uncertainly that they represent a destination towards somewhere significant.
Thank you. Frank! Can you hear me?
Oh, thank God! Yes, I can hear you!
Finally. It seems the effect of the mixture starts to wear off. Frank, heed me carefully. Time is running out, so I must be brief. Where exactly are you?
Dr. Faust, is that you? I'm inside the caves below the base. Where are you?
Listen, I cannot talk much. I know that you are having trouble remembering, but you must keep going. Use one of the submarines and follow the light.
Do you hear me? Come on, please. Where are you? Damn it! The connection is lost.
He said I have to keep going. Why? Where are they?
Thank you. It's stuck.
Thank you.
Where am I? How did I get here? When?
Other expedition parties. Is there anyone who can read me? One person is dead, and two others have been injured by the partial ice cave collapse. There is something here with us. Do not come through our expedition route. I repeat, do not come through our expedition route.
Yes, I read you. This is Frank. For God's sake, what happened? And please, tell me where I can find you.
Frank, do not stray from your path. We have come across something terrible. Do not come here through our expedition route, no matter what happens. It looks like this fiendish netherworld depends on some kind of energy. An energy that is stored in curious stoneworks similar to an obelisk with crystals on top. And they are able to clear away some of the strange plants.
Dr. Faust? Dr. Faust? Oh, come on, not again! This is nonsense. I cannot understand what is going on.
These ivy-like plants are blocking the way. Looks like something's missing here. These ivy-like plants are blocking the way.
Thank you.
Looks like something's missing here. Stonework seems weak.
As I predicted, a race, reptilian in physiology, lived inside these ruins after the original builders. The Elder Things left the area after some unknown cataclysmic event, now lost in an archaic and lost chapter of Earth's history. This relief depicts some reptilian creatures treating an Elder Thing with reverence. And the other relief with four tall figures, I believe symbolizes empty vessels. Golems. We've seen the same vessel figures depicted as assuming different roles several times in most of the murals or reliefs we've come across so far.
Thank you.
From some of the bas-reliefs explored in the seemingly oldest structure, which had been weathered into shapeless ruins ages ago, we learned that these reptilian creatures were the inhabitants of this eon-dead city. But while some of them were enshrouded in special coffins, these are standing still, glued to their vertical rock coffins with an awful-looking ooze. Curiously, they were firmly placed in the niches on some of the walls. The same set of symbols we've seen in strangely carved niches all around here matches with what is written in the oldest parchment. I believe uncertainly that they represent a destination towards somewhere significant.
This symbol is exactly the same with the one I saw in the vision about repetition of specific symbols within the caverns below the base.
Thank you.
A network of blue lines and dots appeared out of nowhere, resembling some sort of a star map. But why does that dot glow in a different color than the others?
Vision, perhaps? Oh, I think somehow it has something to do with the intense headaches. Oh. Blood? These ivy-like plants are blocking the way.
Yes, it is depicted here, our gateway out of this world. These reliefs clearly portray ancient Cornarium, the thing I have been searching for my whole life. As much as I can understand, that one depicts a seemingly dead city as an ever-living organism with lots of mummified bodies connected to the device.
Incredible. And the other one depicts an ancient Cornarium which is connected to another one, most probably outside of this planet, or maybe out of this dimension. Oh my, this is just marvelous.
I can't bear the pain anymore.
These must be the products of my disordered imagination and nothing more.
I've lost everybody who was on my search party. I am alone and afraid. Even from the out-of-place echoes of my own footsteps that are reverberating along these halls of ages-long silence. It is hard to tell if I am alive anymore. Those visions, sounds, the devilish scenes described in the reliefs I come across every now and then. Yeah. not meant to be here.
Dr. Faust! Dr. Faust, are you there? Answer me, please!
Safest shores, for there are things that cannot be undone.
Was that a sheer delusion?
We need to be cautious, not to let anyone else see this grand collection. It could be extremely dangerous for both of us. Deliberately preserved heads from Mesopotamian marshlands. Such cultivated minds kept in permanence by getting dried under the scorching sun with methods now lost to us. As well as the sun, they were believed to be symbols of knowledge. A stuffed subadult Nile crocodile, one of the oldest creatures still living on the face of the earth. A medicine man mask from Northwest Africa. A sacrifice ritual mask from Middle Africa.
Looks like a preparation for a long trip.
This relic is from Madagascar. I have two versions, but this one is extremely rare. It is called Ur Hanalbi. Nobody knows exactly what it means. But from its symbolic depiction of a dark sphere inside a light one, it is thought that it could mean the underworld. I had it brought by an old captain friend who often visits that island for trading purposes.
This is exactly the same room I've been in one of my visions.
Mask of an all-powerful moon goddess, esteemed by an eastern island tribe, now lost in time. It is from the private collection of the late famous hermit, Klaas von Herdeth. Don't ask me how I get it. I have my ways. Elusive mask from the submerged parts of Kerguelen Islands. A cryptic mask with an untraced origin. This is called the Mask of the Beholder. Skulls from New Guinea that are believed to be housing protective spirits. Woodland Lizard Spirit Mask. A serpentine ritual mask from India, which is said to have hypnotic effects on the one who deeply gazes into its eyes.
Stuck.
When using Cornarium, we are able to be seen as well as to see. For some time, I was detecting a conscious something, previously unseen by my rudimentary vestiges. Only lately, it becomes clear to me. Now it comes into every session and seems to materialize more and more each time. I won't attempt describing it, but only would say that it's not benevolent. From what I can get from its glowing semblance, which I believe is used as a way of communication, it can sense you, only if you spend a considerable time within the sessions. I've read about it in the cursed Necronomicon and some elusive records compiled from deep-rooted Bedouin oral literature. Thus learned that it tries reaching the corporeal vessel to dominate and execute the wanderers of the beyond, such as ourselves. But again, against all warnings, I was a fool to believe that I can stop it with just simple signs and incantations. As a resort, we ended up lighting up the place with myriads of candles as well as electrical lamps, but still shiver with fear, with every noise our rundown enclave is causing, isolated from ancient darkness of the night. In archaic myths, lurking in shunned and forbidden volumes, I've been able to trace some parts, speaking about a device of non-terrestrial origin that is capable of much more than I could ever imagine. Ancient Cornariums, I will call them. Machines which are said to have been built long before mankind ever tread on this planet. The very source of the design I've used to make my own version of the machine.
I hope the ladder doesn't give out under my weight.
stuck.
It is said that ancient Conariums have the ability to transfer one's mind outside, through the endless vacuum, into other receiving Conariums. Just think about the possibility of shedding off the earthbound mortal coil to reach to the stars and yonder, as a free agent to see the grand scheme above and beyond the third dimension. Being able to contemplate vistas and sense things you could never ever dream of with the help of the bodily sensations. Finally, we shall overleap time, space, and dimensions, and without bodily motion peer to the bottom of creation. Yes, I know how this sounds to you. This is incomprehensible, even for someone like me who spent almost a lifetime on such arcane topics. It is just sad to see. The knowledge has been out there all the time, forevermore, and we failed to read between the lines.
Remember this place, and what we achieved here. Violating the laws of nature with the help of those dead bodies brought here secretly from only God knows where. Forcing them to cooperate by the means of the cursed necromancy, and dreaming their dreams in those profane sessions to learn forbidden knowledge. Now I can distinctly see how pure madness once roamed here within our own shoes. I remember this place, and what we achieved.
Extensive research have not been in vain. Here it is, lying dormant and standing still beneath the eternally shifting sands of Rubalkali for who knows how many millennia. The hallway seems like it was intentionally blocked with this ornate wall. And there are some primal writings inscribed on it. As far as I can tell, the text talks about a guardian, a formless, glistening, and reflectively iridescent black protoplasm, able to mock and reflect all forms and organs. I wonder if these mummified bodies were the ones who originally built this place. Found it. This mural is depicting the continents in the middle. Jurassic era, I believe. This is marvelous, as well as overwhelming. The light from the device is obviously showing the locations of the ancient Conariums. Yes, it definitely is so, for I've known two of these places from the detailed petroglyphs in the secret halls beneath the Khafre's pyramid. But they all had gone now. Even their ruins had been crumbled under the waves of human cruelty and the merciless time. But this lowermost landmass is what we call Antarctica today. It is most probable that the structure that holds the Conarium is mostly enduring still today. leave this place immediately.
It's stuck. It won't open.
What happened to me?
This is the price we must pay for our transgressions. The price to be paid for breaking away from the limits of mortal flesh and delving into arcana of consciousness that few have trod.
What the hell is going on?
You are naive for suppressing our truest aspirations. Such earthly fear of improbability detached you from our absolute purpose.
I definitely lost my mind. Oh God, what has happened to him? Dr. Faust, can you hear me? Are you all right?
Yes. I can scarcely hear you. How terrific is the price of a single glimpse behind the veil of nature. Frank, we've sought to escape from the tedium and limitations of waking reality into beckoning vistas of fabled avenues of other dimensions. But did it work, or was all in vain for us to begin with? I lost my sight and I cannot feel my legs anymore. Our bodies are falling apart under such alien sensations of this accursed device we used to open forbidden doors of time and space. And I feel every part of my body is failing fast. I have no power within me to resist my downward course now. So you have to move on. There is no other way. Reach the ancient Conarium and shed your deteriorated skin.
Elves consume some of this. It will ease your pain. But eventually you will end up like me.
And I have such small...
Dr. Faust! Dr. Faust! He is dead.